Hello and welcome back to my channel, Dizzy Doggo, where I authentically and awkwardly share my life with you. Currently, a big part of my life is art. I just graduated with a Bachelor of Fine Arts, very fancy. I'm not sure how useful a degree in fine arts is during a pandemic, but I mean, capitalism is really out here trying to get us to define our worth by our usefulness, and I'm not buying it. So, you get it? Buying into capitalism? Not doing it. That was so bad. I'm gonna redo that clip. To keep things as authentic and awkward as possible, I'm gonna be leaving up my old YouTube videos and exposing my soul to all of you, so you're welcome. But moving forward, I want to revisit something that I've been wanting to do for a while. So if you do look back at my old videos, which I hope you don't, one of the videos is about Ana Mendieta, and it was supposed to be part of a series about Latina artists. And I never ended up making any more videos. I hadn't checked my YouTube channel in a while. The last video I made, I think, was like 2 years ago. And when I went back to check, I saw that that video about Ana Mendieta was actually my most successful one. It had like over 500 views, which granted is not a lot, but I only have like 20 subscribers or something like that. So I don't know, I was very proud and very encouraged too. It just affirmed to me that this is what I want to be doing. I love art, I love history, I love connecting to people, I love helping people connect to art and connect to their own history, and so that's what I'm gonna try and keep doing. I remember one time at school, one of my professors was sharing this story with us about one of his old students. In regards to one of his classmates' work, the kid said something like, "I like this painting because it reminds me of my mom." And our professor laughed with us about it and used it as an example of how not to talk about art. While I maybe understand the point that he was trying to get at, what I don't think is helpful is to completely dismiss that comment. Clearly, there was a reason why this work reminded him of his mom, and I think it's worth looking into that. He had an emotional connection to it. And an emotional and personal point of entry into a work is no less valid than an intellectual point of entry. This is why artists even make work. We're all coming from our own subjective experiences, and no artist gets to determine the meaning of a work for everyone, and no professor or art scholar gets to determine what a work means to everyone either. Everyone approaches a work with their own baggage. I could say something like the word kite, and it could bring up all this imagery and content for you that it might not for me. I haven't gone to grad school, I haven't studied pedagogy or how to teach, but I'm just interested in exploring this idea of how we communicate through art. I'm not interested in teaching people how to make art, I'm interested in teaching people how to become artists. I just want to help people become more observant of the kinds of decisions that artists are making when they're trying to communicate meaning. 10 people can make a drawing of the same dog or the same flower and each be communicating something different, because what they're really trying to communicate is their personal relationship to that flower. And so when I engage with the work in turn, I am developing my own relationship to the artist's relationship to that flower, and we just keep adding layers of meaning, and I think this is a beautiful thing. I don't think it detracts from the artist's original intent. I think it adds to it and just makes it fuller and richer. This can apply to a lot of things in life. We're so consumed with trying to find the right way when maybe there's just many ways. I was considering cutting that part out, but because, you know, I do believe in absolute truth, praise God, so I didn't want people to like take that statement and run with it. But I just don't think that truth is even the goal of art. It's just communication. So, how can you think through the ideas you're interested in and explore the emotional content that you haven't been able to attach words to? Language is helpful. I love language, but language is not exclusive to just words. You may find it more natural to communicate through images or through movement or through whatever other form of expression you haven't been able to develop the language for yet. There are people who cannot articulate through words, and that does not mean that they're incapable of having complex ideas and complex emotions or being able to make sense of them. So what I'm interested in is empowering people by giving them tools for communicating and telling their own stories, and also being able to understand more about your own history through looking at an artwork versus having to sit down and read a textbook. People consume information in different ways and also share information in different ways, and I think it's important to be able to hone those skills. We're going to approach this exploration by looking at different artists and figuring out why it is that I feel connected to them. So let me know an artist that you think we should all be looking at together, or maybe there's an artist that you've been wanting to know more about, but you didn't really know where to start or how to do that research. I would love to volunteer to do that. I also don't want this to feel like super formal and like I'm trying to be like a museum educator or a professor, because I am not. But I think I also just sometimes I'm kind of teachery in how I carry myself. So it's not even that I'm like trying to be this thing, it's just like sometimes I just nerd and geek out over things. And so, yeah, that's just me, being authentically awkward.